our children have run out of almost run out of soap, baking soaps. So I am doing a rebatch of soap, and I decided to use my soap scraps to do some soap rebatch to remake soap for them. So this is 2.1 kg. Is 2.195, so approximately 2.2 kg, and this is 1.161 kg. So these are soap scraps from different soaps. We have carrot. We have carrot soap, we have carrot and turmeric soap, we have oatmeal and honey soap, we have a little bit of black soap here, we have rice soap, there's some rice soap here, somewhere inside, just different soaps. I've had these scraps for some time, like about 6 months or so, if not more than. So this is my crock pot. I set it on low, and here goes in the scraps. So I'm going to melt this down, and the liquid I'm going to use is this. Sorry, I spilled a little. This is the tea my children took and did not finish, so I'm going to use it as my liquid instead of water. So my soap is going to come out extra creamy and nourishing on your skin. I intend to do some body butters for them too, because they've run out of butters. So I will take you along on that one with me, but for now let me get this melted down for now. So I'm just going to pour in the tea. Sorry, I'm trying to charge my power bank here, so this is it. Pouring in the tea. I do not intend to add any other super fats to this, because almost all my soaps, if not all of them, are all super fatted soaps. So this I'm going to leave like this. I'm going to cover it with a towel or with a cloth, a thick cloth, and I'll just leave it for it to stay. It's actually on high right now, but I think I'll keep it on low. Okay, and cover it with these my thick cloths that I use as a spread whenever I'm making soaps. This is an old bedspread. I did have a towel once, but I converted the towel to something that I use to wrap my hair whenever I wash my hair. So this is to help to hold the heat, not allow the heat to escape. So it helps to melt the soap fast. So with this, I think we're going to have some good amount of soap that could last them throughout the year. I think throughout the year if possible. So
because these soap shavings are relatively fresh, I am going to be adding about 3 ounces of distilled water now. And if I need to add a little bit more later, I can do that. So it's better to start. This was my lesson I learned last time. It's better to start out cautiously and add more rather than add too much on the upfront part. So I'm going to go ahead. I just have this on low. My crock pot's on low. This is a real slow process. It's a great thing to do on a busy day when you've got other things going on in your soap studio, if you need to label or It's been about 10 to 15 minutes here. You can see some condensation. It's heating up very slowly, but I'm going to go ahead and kind of mush down and see how we're doing. Get that coconut milk powder sort of mushed in here. It's not really stirrable yet, but just sort of flipping it around. I want to heat it and throw in the mold, but I want this to be smooth and whipped and fluid, so we're going to keep going. But, you know, that's when you rebatch, there's no hard and fast rules. You kind of just do it to the point where you like it. So it just depends on what you're going for. I want to try my hand at whipping this again and making a really light, fluffy, floating type soap, but you definitely don't have to do that when you're rebatching. You can just melt it down and throw it in a mold, and you've got perfectly good soap. So actually, I am going to stick this in here and just sort of whip it up. Hopefully the whipping of this will break up some of these chunks. So I'm going to regret it if I do. So I'm going to hold off. Even though it's tempting to add just a little more, I'm going to wait. And most of the fragrance is actually steaming off of this, and it's just basically smelling kind of like a soap smell. So if that can look like baby diaper color, so if I need to mix this up and add something else, we will definitely do that.